Tuesday. Sunshine and clouds mixed. High 83. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
At the end of the day, my hands are beat up.
Especially during the winter times, hands are splitting, cracking, making it very difficult to do my job.
O'Keefe's Working Hands. Guaranteed relief for dry hands that crack and split.
Best stuff we've ever used.
It just works.
Learn more at workinghands.com.
This is Kathleen. Setting up the perfect wedding day starts with her minor arthritis pain and two pills. Afternoon arrives and feeling good, but her knee pain returns. That's two more pills. The evening's event brings laughter, joy, and more pain.
What's that? Like six pills today?
Yeah. I can take two Aleve for all day relief.
Really?
For my arthritis pain, I now choose Aleve.
Two pills, all day strong, all day long. And now, introducing Aleve PM for a better AM.
Okay, Patrick, one more stop.
Let's go base, sharp, blitz.
Base, sharp, blitz.
When the game's on the line.
Okay, this is for the game.
The NFL trusts Duracell Quantum to power their game day communication.
Abort, he's keeping it.
Duracell Quantum lasts up to 35% longer than the competition.
Hi, I'm Jay Farner, president of Quicken Loans, and we're here in Detroit with our amazing team members. Let's meet some of them. People have heard a lot about HARP, but what's HARP?
It is the Home Affordable Refinance Program, and it is a government program that lets homeowners refinance if their home is underwater.
The average savings for one of our HARP programs is about $250 a month, which is a nice chunk of change.
Tell us about the HARP program. How does it work?
All you do is you call Quicken Loans for a free mortgage review.
Okay.
We figure out what we can do for you, and if you're in a good spot, we'll let you know immediately.
Okay. And we're going to walk you through your options. We're going to customize that solution based on exactly what your individual needs are.
And for the fourth year in a row, J.D. Power has ranked Quicken Loans highest in the nation in customer satisfaction.
What makes the HARP program so special?
It's a really easy process. From start to finish, we're doing it in 30 days. There's usually less paperwork. Very often, they don't even need an appraisal. It's easy.
Let's face it. Life happens on your wood floors. And, well, life can be hard on them. So to keep them beautiful, despite life's little ups and downs, trust Bona for quick and easy everyday cleaning, long-lasting shine, and a lifetime of protection. Safe for your floors? Green Guard certified for a healthier home. Everyday solutions for clean and beautiful floors. No matter what. Bona, recommended by professionals since 1919.
What are you doing with our security system?
Upgrading. I'm switching us to Xfinity Home. Now we'll get 24/7 professional monitoring that we can arm and disarm from anywhere. Best of all, it uses our existing equipment, so switching over is easy.
Yeah, that old security system wasn't the greatest.
On to my next quest. Weirdo!
Don't be old-fashioned. Xfinity subscribers at Xfinity Home for $29.95 a month for 12 months. Plus, for a limited time, get a free security camera when you call today. Call 1-800-XFINITY now.
4656.
Or go to HumanaBigBook.com. The savings are too big to miss.
3 nights of weather. You shouldn't watch alone.
What was that?
Our Halloween marathon, Wicked in the Weather, starting Wednesday night at 8 on the Weather Channel.
You are watching the Weather Channel. It's time for the tropical update. And if you haven't heard, we have a new tropical storm. Here's Kyla with more.
Yeah, just when you thought it was safe to keep your eyes off the tropics, we've got two things to look at here. Tropical storm Hannah plaguing Central America. And then we look over to the Pacific and we have an Invest 93E. So let's get you up to speed on what's happening with these. Here's tropical storm Hannah. And you can see it really rolling in here to Honduras and Nicaragua. The wind's about 40 miles per hour, pressure 1,005 millibars. It's moving rather slowly to the west at about 7 miles per hour. But if you look at the enhanced satellite, you start to see where the higher cloud tops there are in those brighter colors and the oranges and pinks, and they are bringing all of that rain in. So certainly that could cause some problems, flooding. Yeah, it could make it very inconvenient for those in this part of the country, in this part of the world, I should say. Tropical storm warnings are up from Honduras's coast down into Nicaragua today. And this one kind of popped up rather quickly. We can see it's going to move inland as well as we get into Tuesday morning, start to slow it down. But before before it takes off, it's going to dump an awful lot of rain, 5 to 8 inches in some pockets along the coast there in Honduras. You could see more 1 to 2 as we head down into Nicaragua, but certainly enough to be a big nuisance. Then we head over to the Pacific and we look at what the National Hurricane Center has been keeping an eye on here, Invest 93E, and they say about an 80% chance of this developing. Right now the winds at about 30 miles per hour. This is the development area right here in this area that you see, and you can see it's out in the ocean, and we do expect that that is where this one is going to stay. So here it is. We're going to take a look at what the forecast models predict it will do. And this one, a little good news with this, as we expect that it will just track on out to sea. It looks like our graphic here has decided to take a break, but it stays out to sea, and this one should not be a problem for land, but we will certainly keep an eye on it. Vivian.
Right. It goes to show that even though hurricane season is winding down, there's still a month to go, and we'll continue to keep you updated. In fact, we're counting down to the top October hurricanes on record. Last hour, we showed you number 2 on the list. Now, the 1950s Hurricane King. Oh, we'll talk more about this one. That's our number 1 hurricane from senior hurricane specialist Brian Norcross.
This storm was the strongest hurricane ever so far north and produced the strongest winds ever recorded at the Battery in New York City. I bet you're thinking Hurricane Sandy, but it's not. Hurricane Hazel decimated nearly 200 miles of the North and South Carolina coastline. And to this day, it's the benchmark storm for North Carolina. Winds gusted to 100 miles per hour or more from Virginia to New York, knocking out power for millions. So one of the great storms of the 20th century, Hurricane Hazel, is our number 1 October hurricane from 60 years ago this month. But what about our most recent October monster, Superstorm Sandy? More than 1,000 miles across, Sandy pushed record storm surge against the Northeast coast 2 years ago and did more than $60 billion in damage, the second highest total of any storm in history. But Sandy technically was not a hurricane at landfall. It had morphed into more of a nor'easter. So technically, Sandy does not make our list. So Hurricane Hazel from 1954 is the number 1 October hurricane. I'm senior hurricane specialist Brian Norcross.
All right. Thanks very much, Brian.
Yes. So we go from that kind of scary weather to how your Monday is going. And I have to say, we've gotten a lot of really cool pictures that people have sent in Facebook and Twitter today. So thanks for sending them in. Take a look at this. Independence, Ohio. This is Lou Cherney, and he woke up to ice on his windshield.
Say what?
Yes. And some falling leaves. You see the foliage if you look to the back of that picture?
Yes, I do. But take a look at these falling leaves and the cute pup. Okay, this is Jennifer Winston's dog as he enjoys the beautiful fall weather. Thank you so much, Jennifer, for
and
sending us
a picture.
And I
have to say, Jen Winston, a fellow Tri-Delta friend of mine. So, hi, Jen.
Really?
I see her dog's pictures all the time. I love them.
Thank you,
And this
Jennifer.
One in Oklahoma, we've got Michael Tanner and beautiful fall foliage. Very nice, guys. Thanks for sending all these in.
All right, so I need to ask my Soros to send some pictures in as well.
Well, if you want to keep up with the mighty Tri-Delta, you might want to do that.
Now.
Hey, Dave Schwartz and Mark Elliott are picking things up in 60 seconds. They'll have your forecast.
Currently in our area, 82 degrees under partly cloudy skies. This afternoon, mostly sunny. High 81. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, cloudy intervals. Low 71. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, sunshine and clouds mixed. High 83. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Wind and rain, even snow. October's a tricky month when it comes to weather, and this week all eyes will need to be focused on the forecast for Halloween.
That one. What? Halloween.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, we're going to take an early look at what's in store and where you may have to dress the children in layers underneath that costume.
It's kind of like a horror show happening in slow motion.
One of our United States is threatened by a river of fire. We take a look at the speed of the lava as a town is on edge, awaiting evacuation orders.
And call it a comeback. What was once Hurricane Ana is back and causing havoc now for the Pacific Northwest. What's still in store and why it's not the only former hurricane with an unusual route. From the Weather Channel headquarters in Atlanta, you are watching Weather Center Live. And thanks so much for joining us today. I'm Mark Elliott in for Alex Wilson.
And I'm Dave Schwartz. Now, if people are watching from the Weather Channel in Atlanta, what are we watching?
We're watching with the new 4D television and being able to see everyone who's watching at home.
Okay. Oh, that's right.
It's creepy, right?
Hey, you know, the hallowed evening is fast approaching, Mark, and there's going to be some very ghostly and ghastly weather in the Northeast. More on that in a minute. But the other corner of the country still in store for more heavy rain and storms.
Yeah, the Pacific Northwest. Take a look at this. People near Seattle trying to restore power today. Winds toppled trees and power lines, and right now still about 10,000 customers in Washington State and Oregon without power from the first storm, which came through over the weekend. And even a sailor was killed when he was blown overboard during a race near Olympia, Washington. Now, people in the Pacific Northwest have to get ready for the next series of strong storms. So here's Dave with a look at those.
Thanks, Mark. You know, gale warnings are now in effect for this evening, tonight, and tomorrow, especially in the morning here in Washington and Oregon, right along the coast. And in Seattle, we've gotten a jump start on the wet season. The wet season begins now for Seattle and runs through about March or April. Well, we've had over 36 inches of rain so far this year. That's a foot above average. So no drought going on, at least in western Washington. All okay. We're mostly cloudy. It's kind of a bright sky, too, sun from time to time. But as we look far offshore, we see some of the energy just coming into the western edge of the screen, and that's going to be in here tonight. If we switch from radar, which is rather puny, to the satellite image, you can really see that we're in for something. Again, there's the dry air. There's the circulation of the parent low under Alaska, the Alaska low. And there's some thundershowers out here, I'm pretty sure. So that's going to be moving in here this evening. Seattle, Portland, showers, thundershowers, wind really picking up, and the rain will really be coming down. Now, tomorrow, some of that storm moves further inland. We'll have snow in the mountains. So if you have some plans to take you over US 2 or I-90, make sure you call ahead or check online. Now, since there's a tropical hookup here, we head to the lab and our hurricane expert, Michael Lowry.
Hey, Dave. That's right. This one you can trace all the way back to that tropical storm that formed in the Pacific Ocean 2 weeks ago. Let's show you on our globe here. This is the remnants of tropical storm. Actually, it was once a hurricane, Ana, that formed in the Pacific Ocean. It looks like we're over here in the wrong side of the globe. We're in the Arabian Sea and the North Indian Ocean. But I promise you, it's that same system 52 advisories ago from the Central Pacific Hurricane Center. And that whole system moving 3,000 miles across the Pacific Ocean in merging with a non-tropical area of low pressure, that big storm system that's now beginning to push into parts of the Pacific Northwest, causing some problems there in the Olympics, Olympic National Park, the Skokomish River. We have to watch for flooding there. That is all helped out by the remnants, basically energized by the remnants of a tropical storm and Hurricane Ana there in the Pacific Ocean. We're going to talk about this one here in a minute. We do have a new tropical storm in the Atlantic Ocean, but in the meantime, Dave, we'll go ahead and send it back to you.
Now, Michael, before we let you go, switching gears just a little bit, something really unusual happened this morning in the tropics. We got a named tropical storm in the Atlantic Basin that might have taken some people by surprise.
Yeah, that's what I was just talking about, Dave. This is Ana, and this is one we kind of wrote off last week. And even the Hurricane Center this morning only giving it a 10% chance of development and becoming our next tropical storm in the Atlantic, now inland over parts of Honduras and Nicaragua. Here is the latest information, a 40-mile-per-hour hour tropical storm, so kind of borderline. 39 miles per hour is where those tropical storm force winds start, moving west at 7 miles per hour further inland. Here's what it looks like on the visible picture. Not a whole lot to write home about, just some clouds and the spin to those clouds. Very small system that it continues to push inland. A tropical storm warning is up for parts of Honduras and Nicaragua. Those probably will be dropped later today, though, as this continues to weaken. The main concern here and the main impact is going to be the heavy rainfall as this progresses inland. There was a lot of rain that fell over here over the past 7 days over parts of Central America, even extending all the way into parts of Mexico. The good news, Dave and Mark, is that the models aren't really showing a ton of rainfall with this, but it'll need to be watched because it can lead to those very dangerous and deadly mudslides and landslides. Back to you.
Thanks, Mike. And you know what? It's going to be on a lot of people's minds in the Northeast this week. What will Halloween night be like? And here's a hint. Buy a costume with layers in places like New York, D.C., and Boston. I remember many a Halloween growing up in New Jersey where you had to put a coat on either above or underneath the costume, have to work that in somehow, because we're going to have a dramatic return to fall-like temperatures in the Northeast Corridor just in time for Halloween. Ahead of it, we're seeing lots of warm air, but this cold front comes through. The northwest flow kicks in, much cooler conditions. Temperatures get back to near average, but they will feel cooler than that because of how warm it has been. So that, you know, contrast will really, you'll notice the change. Like tomorrow, 71 in New York, that's 11 degrees above average. By Wednesday, though, you start to see what's happening back here towards the Great Lakes, low to mid-50s in Buffalo and Pittsburgh. And some of that air starts to make its way back towards the Northeast Corridor. So by Thursday, New York City, 58, now switching to a degree below average, and that will only continue as we work our way into Friday. The average high in New York, 61, again, well above average tomorrow, but a big stair step down all the way to Friday, right? Mid-50s in New York City, so it is going to be dramatically cooler there for you. We might even see a couple of snowflakes by the weekend. Dave, over to you.
How about them apples, huh? Well, after the Halloween thrills, there could be some chills. Later this hour, we're going to show you who could see the first snowfall of the season this weekend. But up next, the lava is still slowly creeping towards homes and businesses. We'll bring you an update from Hawaii, where evacuations could be imminent.
Didn't know, people with the flu can spread it up to 6 feet away. Or that flu can make chronic conditions worse. Or that experts say anyone who lives or works with infants should be vaccinated. Maybe you didn't know all the stuff your Rite Aid pharmacist knew the whole time. But maybe, since you already went and got your flu shot at Rite Aid without hassle or appointment, maybe you didn't need to know any of that. Rite Aid. With us, it's personal.
At Planners, we know how to throw a remarkable holiday party. Just serve classy snacks and be a gracious host, no matter who shows up. Richard, didn't think you were going to make it.
Hey, sorry about last week. I don't know what got into me.
Yeah, well, forgive and forget. Kind of. I don't think so. Did you
guys see that? Do you like nuts?
7 a.m. on AMHQ.
Let's get you in front of today's weather.
The biggest weather hour anywhere.
What a gorgeous start.
Weekday mornings on the Weather Channel. The wildest weather ever caught on camera.
Oh my God!
Tonight. Tomorrow night. Every weeknight. Wild weather at 8 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 82 degrees under partly cloudy skies. This afternoon, mostly sunny. High 81. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, cloudy intervals. Low 71. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, sunshine and clouds mixed. High 83. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
every Monday night this fall.
What is it that produces these things?
The Weather Channel unlocks the secrets of the earth. The all-new season continues tonight at 9 on the Weather Channel.
It's here in your floor's crevices that vacuums leave microscopic allergens like these pollens and mold spores. But the Dyson DC65 uses a self-adjusting cleaner head for improved suction on hard floors and deep cleaning on carpets. While powerful cycling technology captures even microscopic dirt and safely locks it all in here. DC65 sucks up more dust, dirt, and allergens than any other vacuum across carpets and hard floors.
That disease is for older people. Not me. I take good care of myself. I'm active. I never saw it coming. It hit me like a ton of bricks. Pneumococcal pneumonia was horrible. The fatigue, the chest pains, difficulty breathing. It put me in the hospital. You don't want to go through what I did.
If you're over 50, talk to your doctor. You may be able to prevent it.
Your heart is precious. One of many ways to support its health is new TrueHeart from Oneaday. It's the only heart health supplement with ingredients to both help lower bad cholesterol and support healthy blood pressure, and also includes CoQ10. Try new TrueHeart.
It's real. It's now or never. You know, you pack and you got to get out.
It's going to be sad watching our house go down.
We're all in needles and pins, you know, waiting.
It's kind of like a horror show happening in slow motion.
We're praying really hard that it'll spare us on this area here, because my whole family's in this subdivision.
Right now, a slow-motion disaster is creeping toward an American town. The Kilauea volcano, which has been erupting for years now, has that lava flow from a volcano that's threatening more than 50 homes in Pahoa. The lava, 2,000 degrees, hot enough to torch absolutely anything in its path. And that 23 miles from the volcano over towards the town has now been eaten by that slow motion lava flow. The pace is slow but steady, but look at these series of pictures that we have. Anything in the path of this lava flow absolutely disintegrating, including those barbed wire fences. The flow has actually split into two lobes, one moving at about 10 to 15 yards per hour. That's about one football field every day. The other much slower, just a few hundred yards from the main road in and out of Pahoa. And because of that, officials have gone door to door, letting people know that evacuations could begin very soon. Now, one of the most destructive moments started yesterday. The lava flow moved into the Pahoa Cemetery. It covered several burial plots and burned monuments that had been there for decades. But homes could be next. And Dave, it looks like only a matter of time before it does reach those homes.
That is scary. I mean, how are you going to stop that? Well, we want to welcome Dr. Charles Mandeville. Now, he is a program coordinator with the U.S. Geological Survey, and he joins us by phone. Good to have you with us here, Dr. Mandeville.
Thank you for having me.
Now, we understand that you are tracking two lobes of the lava right now. Can you give us an update on both of them?
Yeah, the northernmost lobe is about 40 meters wide, and that's the one that passed Pahoa Cemetery yesterday, and it's moving at a rate of about 240 to 360 meters per day, and that's as of 5 p.m. Right now, the faster finger, the northern one, is about 300 meters downslope of Apaha Street and 660 meters upslope from Pahoa Village Road. The lower one is basically traveling at about 9 meters per hour as of 5 p.m. last night, and the two lobes may actually join as they come through the cemetery near the northeast end of the pasture.
Now, certainly
these things can be outrun, however, they can't be stopped, and they incinerate everything in their path.
Can they be diverted away from people's homes, for example?
There have been incidences in other countries where lava flows have been diverted, but that is not something that is done in Hawaii, actually.
I see.
There are strong cultural reasons for not doing so.
Uh-huh.
Now, we've heard about methane gas explosions near the lava flow. In 30 seconds, can you explain just what happens, how that happens?
Yes. As the lava flow traverses vegetation, it actually incinerates it, and some of those gases given off from the burning vegetation can be trapped by the lava, but eventually sufficiently high pressure will build up so that a small explosion occurs. Fortunately, these aren't the major hazard because they're small explosions and they haven't really lofted rocks out of a crater.
Thank you, Dr. Mandeville from the U.S. Geological Survey on that lava flow in Hawaii. Well, from Bermuda to the U.K. to Greece, the impacts of Hurricane Gonzalo have been widespread. Coming up next, the eye-opening path this storm and its energy have taken and the damage it's done around the world.
What's in a can of Del Monte green beans?
All I'd want is you to be my sweet honeybee. And if I was a tree growing tall and green, all I'd want is you to shade me and be my leaves.
Grown in America, picked and packed at the peak of ripeness, with no artificial ingredients. Del Monte, bursting with life.
Approaching Medicare eligibility? Don't put off checking out your Medicare options until 65. Now is a good time to get the ball rolling. Medicare only covers about 80% of Part B medical costs. The rest is up to you. That's where AARP Medicare Supplement Insurance Plans, insured by United Healthcare Insurance Company, come in. Like all standardized Medicare Supplement Insurance Plans, they could help save you in out-of-pocket medical costs. Taking informed steps really makes a difference later. That's what it means to go long. Call now and request this free decision guide and explore the range of AARP Medicare supplement plans. All plans like these let you choose any doctor or hospital that accepts Medicare patients. These are the only Medicare supplement insurance plans endorsed by AARP. Call now and request your free decision guide and start gathering the information you need to help you go long.
For over a decade, doctors have been prescribing Nexium to patients just like you. For many, prescription Nexium helps heal acid-related erosions in the lining of the esophagus. There is risk of bone fracture and low magnesium levels. Side effects may include headache, abdominal pain, and diarrhea. If you have persistent diarrhea, contact your doctor right away. Other serious stomach conditions may exist. Avoid if you take clopidogrel. Nexium 40 mg is only available by prescription. Talk to your doctor. For free home delivery, enroll in Nexium Direct today.
It's just freaking me out.
If you miss this Sunday night on the Weather Channel,
this is crazy.
You'll never know how twisted weather can be.
Is it real? Yeah, it's real.
At The Watershed, we believe in recovery. We believe that every alcoholic and addict deserves the opportunity to be healed. Our team of addiction professionals will address the underlying causes of your addiction while treating you with dignity and respect. We've helped thousands of patients recover from this seemingly hopeless state of mind and body. Addicts can recover. Addicts do recover. No matter how hopeless the situation seems, the time to get help is now. Call The Watershed today.
Guess what? The brand new season of...
Oh, my God.
The brand new season of American Dad is...
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
Okay, we got it. The brand new season of American Dad is on...
Oh, my God.
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 The brand new season of American Dad is on TBS.
Oh. Yeah, you could say we're excited.
They said I wasn't good enough for TBS. How do you like me now, voices in my head?
Catch the brand new, edgier season Mondays at 9, 8 Central. Only on TBS and the Watch TBS app.
Go.
And shipping is always free.
Visit deal-dash.com and start bidding today.
The wildest weather ever caught on camera.
Oh my God.
Tonight, tomorrow night, every weeknight, Wild Weather at 8 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. This afternoon, mostly sunny. High 81. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, cloudy intervals, low 71. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 83. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Well, there is nothing that ruins a good, planned-out Halloween costume like a winter coat. Unfortunately, some of you are going to need those coats this Friday. We're going to talk temperatures coming up at the bottom of the hour. But first, we've got tropics still going. Tropical update time in the lab with Michael Lowry and Dave Schwartz. Guys, over to you.
And not only two of us, but what's our next tropical storm? We have a name, right?
Yeah, this is one that we almost wrote off last week, Dave, and quickly developed right under our noses this morning. Take a look at this. Going back to last night, didn't look like a whole lot. You were just mentioning coming on here how the outflow looks pretty good, and he's right. The upper level winds are really light over this. That allowed that surface circulation to spin up very quickly just to the east of Honduras and Nicaragua during the early, early morning hours. And here we have tropical storm Hannah. There was an observation there, and there were some satellite estimates showing us that those winds at least 40 miles per hour. Tropical storm strength winds start at 39 miles per hour. Dave, now this is moving inland, just in over the border here of Honduras and Nicaragua. The main impact, not going to be so much the wind, it's going to be the heavy rainfall.
The rain.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can see it kind of wound up right here. There is definitely a circulation down here. Sometimes when the sun comes up and you look at the visible picture, it tells you a lot more than what you can see with the enhanced picture that doesn't give us that level of detail down near the surface of the ocean. Tropical storm warnings are up just for a small fraction of the coast here. I suspect they'll be dropped later today as this continues to move inland and basically just rain itself out. But that rainfall, I want to show you the rainfall forecast here, because some of those areas really don't need the rainfall. There have been a lot of rain here over the past week or so. Greatest flood risk areas up here, but hopefully we can get that rain to stay down to the south, Dave.
Alrighty, well, so that's the latest on the latest. Hannah, let's check in with Mark.
And you know what, we're gonna stay in the lab because we wanna take a look at the three faces of Gonzalo. Of course, it made landfall in Bermuda as a Category 2 hurricane. That was back on October 17th, and you're seeing that in the top left portion of your screen. But the system kept going from there, bringing rough winds and surf to parts of the UK, and then get this, snowfall to the Alps. So here to take a look at the longevity of this system is once again Michael Lowry. Michael, this thing seemed to go everywhere.
It really did, Mark. I mean, we had impacts almost across the world with Gonzalo. Let's take you back to October 3rd. This is 2 weeks ago. Actually, this was the same time when Ana formed, which we'll get to in a second, but let's start in the Atlantic Ocean and show you this one as a reminder to folks. This was a very powerful Category 4 hurricane at one point. Moved over Bermuda as a Category 2 hurricane. Lots of damage there. Some estimates $200-300 million in damage.
And what are the chances, right, that the center went right over the island?
I mean, really,
like that?
Yeah, a little small, 20 mile wide island, and you have a little
and
tiny
a 30 mile wide eye
over
and just
a gigantic
perfect.
Atlantic yeah. Ocean. That in itself was just remarkable. And then it became post-tropical. In other words, it lost its warm core. It became more of a cold core system supported by temperature differences in the atmosphere. But you could trace that all the way across parts of the UK. In fact, wind gusts to 108 miles per hour there in Scotland. And then they had a lot of flight delays because of this.
And the wave action, too, was really bad.
The wave action was incredible.
There.
Yeah, we saw some of those pictures just off the coast. And now pushing down over parts of Europe and then creating some snowfall here over the higher terrain.
Wait, flooding across Greece and
flooding
then snow
Greece.
In the higher elevations,
Can't forget
too.
About that as well, yeah. So this one, you know, it just didn't want to go away.
And it's not the only system that we've been watching with just extraordinarily long life.
Here's the other one here. This is Ana. It developed on the 13th or 14th of October, again 2 weeks ago, and that one moved, fortunately for Hawaii, just to their south, but it did bring some heavy rainfall to parts of Oahu and Kauai over the weekend, and then actually looked its best it's looked on Friday. It had a nice little eye to it.
Sure.
And then becoming extra tropical again, but getting wrapped up in those very, very brisk river of mid-latitude winds, and then combining with that big old Pacific storm that's now pushing in toward parts of Canada and then parts of the Pacific Northwest.
So now some of that tropical moisture is kind of enveloped within this already potent Pacific
storm. Right, the
storm.
System would be there regardless,
sure.
But now getting a nice little kick of energy from what's left of Anna.
Which is not what the Pacific Northwest wants to hear after just experiencing another powerhouse storm. Dave, over to you.
And cold air is coming into the Northeast this weekend. That cold front down into the plains right now. And we could get some snow out of this. We'll tell you where and when the flakes could start falling when Weather Center Live continues.
This program brought to you by Progressive. Join over 3 million drivers who switched to Progressive last year.
Just tell us your budget and the Name Your Price tool helps you find a whole range of coverages. No one else gives you options like that.
No one at all.
No one at all.
No one.
Wake up.
Oh. You okay, buddy? I just had a dream that Progressive had this thing called...
Your budget and the Name Your Price tool helps you find a whole...
It isn't a dream, is it?
Nope.
Sorry.
You know that thing freaks me out.
He can hear you. He didn't mean that, Kevin.
Yes, he did.
Keeping our competitors up at night. Now that's Progressive.
Ever since Daryl's wife started using Gain Flings, their laundry smells more amazing than ever.
Honey, isn't that the dog's towel?
Hey, me towel, Sue towel. More scent plus Oxy Boost and Febreze. It's our best Gain ever.
Are you proactive about your heart health? Do you think you get everything you need from your diet? Well, think again. Omega-3 is one of the essential nutrients to support your heart health. But even with a healthy diet, and because our body can't produce them, many people don't get enough. That's why I recommend omega-3 supplements to support your heart health. And a great way to do this is to take MegaRed, the smart choice for your heart health. Because MegaRed's omega-3s are in the same form as your cells, they're easily absorbed by your body. And the omega-3s in MegaRed promote the healthy function of your heart by supporting three markers of heart health. First, the CRP level, a key marker of systemic inflammation. Second, triglycerides, a type of fat measured in the blood. And third, your omega-3 index, which is the amount of omega-3 fatty acids in your body's cells. A higher omega-3 index is associated with better cardiovascular health. In fact, taking MegaRed once daily is clinically proven to significantly increase your level of omega-3s in just 30 days.
For the first time, MegaRed is offering our strongest formula ever in exclusive heart health packages. Simply call 800-803-4974 or visit GetMegaRed.com and find out how you can save over 40% compared to buying in store. Plus, when you order now, you'll get a free gift and free shipping. This is a limited-time offer and not available in stores. MegaRed also comes with a risk-free 30-day money-back guarantee and free lifetime shipping. Make the smart choice for your heart health. Call 800-803-4974 or go to GetMegaRed.com today.
Are you taking MegaRed, the smart choice for your heart?
7 a.m. on AMHQ.
Let's get you in front of today's weather.
The biggest weather hour anywhere.
What a gorgeous start.
Weekday mornings on the Weather Channel. The wildest weather ever caught on camera.
Oh my God!
Tonight, tomorrow night, every weeknight, wild weather at 8 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. This afternoon, mostly sunny. High 81. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, cloudy intervals. Low 71. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, sunshine and clouds mixed. High 83. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Every Monday night. night this fall.
What is it that produces these things?
The Weather Channel unlocks the secrets of the Earth. The all-new season continues tonight at 9 on the Weather Channel.
A town on edge as a slow-moving disaster threatens homes, land, and roads in Hawaii.
Coming up, how an eruption months ago is now forcing officials to consider evacuations. Thanks so much for staying with us on Weather Center Live. I'm Mark Elliott, in for Alex Wilson.
And I'm Dave Schwartz, and I'm in here for myself today, right? Nobody subs for me.
I guess not.
Hey, that lava flow is providing amazing images, but a very real danger. Now, it's part of one of the most unpredictable times of year when it comes to the weather.
Yeah, you know, this week marks the three-year anniversary of the Snowtober storm, also known as the 2011 Halloween Nor'easter. Trick-or-treating had to be canceled due to damage and power outages. There were 3.2 million homes and businesses in 12 different states that lost power. In fact, some parts of Connecticut were without power for 11 days, and damage estimates range from $1 to $3 billion with a B, dollars. So nothing quite that bad in store this year, but we are following the chance for Halloween showers or snow showers. Dave, what are you watching?
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm watching areas of low pressure over the northwest U.S. and southwestern Canada. They're going to team up. One's going to bring in the first shot of cool air into the north. Well, we'll get to that here in a second. Let's talk about the Midwest. It's so lovely outside. Look at Chicago at 72. How about Findlay, Ohio? I just checked their thermometer, 79 degrees. Unbelievable. 59 our dew point, so the moisture's in the air. It feels very comfortable. South-southwest winds here in Chicago will keep it mild till the cold front slides through. And the cold front is right about here. That's going to slide eastward as this trough of low pressure digs across the Great Lakes, eventually into the northeast. As the jet stream reconfigures, so does the temperature setup across the United States. Highs back to near average rather than above average. And by Friday, it's going to be windy to go along with that colder air, too. So enjoy it while you have it. 76 KC, there's 80 in St. Louis. Tomorrow will be cooler, but not ferociously cool. And then as we head toward Wednesday, that cool down heads toward Detroit, where temperatures are in the mid-60s now. We're calling for a forecast of 51. Then, as this cool air moves into the Midwest, it heads for the Northeast. So we'll get in on a couple of days of milder weather, Tuesday and Wednesday here in the Northeast. Then things will begin to cool down. 76 tomorrow in Pittsburgh, but there's the chance for snow by Halloween. Here's Mark to tell you about it.
Yeah, what about that forecast for Halloween and just after? Because we could be talking about early November snow in places like Pittsburgh. I mean, take a look. Pittsburgh sometimes has snow relatively early. In fact, the record snow, October 18th. On average, November 14th is your first day of memorable snow. So we are right kind of in between the earliest and the record. So it's not, and the average, I should say. So it's certainly not out of the question to see snow this time of year in the Pittsburgh area, but it could very well be the first flakes for some coming up this weekend. So maybe you have some late Halloween parties. Yeah, you may very well have some of those coming, some of those snowflakes making an appearance at the party. Now, here's what we're looking at here. This is Alaska, right? We've got this big high group of clouds. You might think that this is our next big storm system, but actually, it's this one. We're going to be able to follow this in the models all the way into the Northeast Corridor. And we're going to do this using what we call in the biz vorticity, but fancy word for mid-level spin in the atmosphere and a general idea of where storms may be getting organized. So watch this little cluster of vorticity or spin in the atmosphere drop down across Canada through the Great Lakes and eventually right off the Northeast coast by Saturday afternoon. And what that means is as a cold front comes through and knocks in some much colder air for the middle of the week, we're going to have a mid-level disturbance, a big area of low pressure. That helps accentuate the cold air. So we've got a storm system forming, the cold air in place, and then the precipitation. And that's all you need for wintry weather, right? Rain showers transition over to a mix of rain and snow showers as you go into Friday night because the cold air comes in, Dave. So by Saturday, look across the Northeast. We're painting it in blue, and we'll fine-tune that forecast as we keep going. Over to you.
How about that, sports fans, huh? A little snow? Not for Seattle. This is what it looks like now. We've got some sun, some clouds, and rain on the way. Here comes another storm. It's like the door is open for storms here in the Northwest. In Portland, we're already running 5 inches below average, so anything we pick up will be, that'll be perfect, huh? That'll give us some more water. And, of course, we get a lot of our water here in Portland from Mount Hood and the glaciers that are sitting atop some of these volcanoes here at the Cascade Mountains. We got more rain on the way, more wind on the way. A gale warning is in effect now. Washington and Oregon coast all the way down to Point Blanco. There is our cold front. There's the rising air motions. We see some heavier showers offshore. Those will be moving in just in time for rush hour this afternoon. Ugh. There's our moist flow. It's going to be with us now for a while. I'm telling you, the door's open. One storm moves through, and then another storm on Wednesday moves through, Wednesday night and into Thursday, and then another one for the weekend. So we'll be painting a lot of green on the map, my friend. Seattle, have the bumper chutes ready to go. That's umbrellas in Eastern talk. Portland, same story. So out there at the Japanese, the Japanese garden should be beautiful this week. Just overlooking downtown Portland, absolutely gorgeous. And if you're a skier, there'll be some high mountain snows in here by tomorrow night. Here's the forecast for Portland, 61 today. Then we pick up the rain and wind tonight. Scattered showers on Wednesday. Mark?
And Dave, we've had a bit of a quiet year when it comes to tornadoes. Up until, anyway, we got to October. Just last week, we had an EF1 tornado touchdown in Washington State. And our severe weather expert breaks down the tornado tally and also shows you why November is no time to let your guard down.
Because of the outbreak of more than 40 tornadoes back in mid-October, this month is actually above average for number of tornadoes. It's just the second time in 2014, the previous in June. Here's what the numbers look like. October through the 24th, we've had 69 preliminary tornadoes. That's 57% above the average to this date, which would be 44, and more than the whole month typically averages, which is 57. So, like I say, we're going to be above average. Here's what the year-to-date total looks like. 820 tornadoes, that's a lot, but it's 31% below the 10-year average of 1,191. So we've had a lot of tornadoes, but fortunately, we have been below average. We'll hope it continues that way, but not necessarily so. What does November typically hold? Well, if you look at the big picture of things, on average, we go from 57 tornadoes in October down to 55 in November, but that doesn't necessarily tell the whole story. Certainly, it's way down from the peak month, which is typically the month of May, but it does not tell the whole story because sometimes some Novembers can have big outbreaks that give two or three times the average. Look at this outbreak back in November 1992. That one had 105 tornadoes, and all five of these rank in the 50 biggest tornado outbreaks for any month in the United States. So while every November is not very active, sometimes with that Gulf of Mexico moisture being drawn northward by low pressure systems and the jet stream coming south, kind of like what happens in the spring, we can get big tornado outbreaks. So don't let your guard down. Keep checking the weather, and stay safe. Back to you.
Thank you, Dr. Forbes. Well, still to come on Weather Center Live. A lava flow on the move since June is inching closer to a small town in Hawaii. Coming up, the final steps before evacuation.
Plus, this light show is just one of our top five videos, but it is number one. We're going to show you what made the top of the list.
That wasn't number one.
It wasn't.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. This afternoon, mostly sunny. High 81. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, cloudy intervals, low 71, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 83, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
tires, not just for performance, but real life performance. So before you get in, get going. Get gone. You need to get a tire that gets you, because life's a road trip. Come on, let's go. Buy four qualifying Cooper tires and get up to a $70 prepaid card by mail. See retailer for details.
Ring, ring.
Progresso.
It's okay that your soup tastes like my homemade.
It's our slow-simmered vegetables and tender white meat chicken.
Apology accepted. I'm watching you, soup people.
Make it Progresso or make it yourself.
There's been flooding throughout the area.
We're getting hail the size of golf balls.
Maglight. Turn your light on, America.
Again.
When we're having this much fun, why quit? And Bounty has no quit in it either. It's two times more absorbent than the leading ordinary brand, and then stays strong so you can use less. Watch how one sheet of Bounty keeps working, while their two sheets just quit. Bounty, the no-quit picker-upper.
What's the best way to tackle football season? New Bounty NFL prints, available at Walmart.
There is something in the people. Something in the sand. There's something in the air. Something in the water. Something in the night. And it's something you can only find here. Jamaica, home of all right. For deals on your trip to Jamaica, book with Delta Vacations.
I've always seen No No on TV and I always wondered if it worked. And it definitely, I can see what everybody talks about now.
It's not a razor. It's not a laser. It's No-No from Radiancy, the number one hair removal system in the world.
It's absolutely okay. No pain.
Can't believe the difference, Al. It's almost hair-free.
No-No gives you no hair with no pain.
Well, I saw it on TV and they said it was painless, right? I didn't really believe it, but now that I'm trying it, it feels completely painless.
And now, No-No is better than ever. Introducing the new No-No Pro. It's up to 35% more powerful. Imagine never having to shave again.
I like a close shave.
Absolutely.
And this is better than that. I mean, it's gone.
No more facial hair. No more embarrassment.
I've always been self-conscious of my hairline, so putting my hair back, this will be perfect for me.
And for that man in your life, there's No-No for him too.
It looks like just like you've got a fresh wax, but like you don't have to go through all the pain.
Call now and we'll send you the cordless No-No Pro in your choice of colors. Featuring an LCD display, it comes with up to 5 treatment levels. Plus, we'll include everything you need to get rid of your unwanted hair. A set of Thermacon tips, specially designed for your face and body. A buffer pad to exfoliate and polish your skin. Plus, act now, and we'll send you the No-No travel case as a free gift. And get this, you can try No-No risk-free for not 30 days, but 60 days with our triple guarantee. If you are not 100% satisfied, return it and we'll refund the purchase price, refund the shipping, and even pay the return postage. Try No-No risk-free today.
I need to get myself one of these right now.
Absolutely.
For your 60-day trial, go to nonopro.com or call 1-800-955-2390. That's 1-800-955-2390.
Sounds like bacon frying, doesn't it?
A little bit.
Lava in Hawaii, slowly smoldering and eating everything in its path. And in its path right now, part of a small Hawaiian town and the main road people there used to get in and out.
And that threat of isolation is why the people of Pahoa are getting ready to evacuate, even preparing for the possibility that they may never see their homes again. NBC's Haley Jackson in Hawaii with a closer look at the damage.
Good morning. This roadblock is about as close as almost anybody can get to the lava flow, which is about a half a mile from where we're standing. People are packing up. They're getting ready to leave their homes, possibly as early as today. Even though this river of lava is taking about 5 hours to cover the length of a football field right now, that's actually the fastest it's been moving in days. Unstoppable, unrelenting, and heading straight toward this village of Pahoa. Hawaiian officials are going door to door to the 40 or 50 homes or so covered by this new evacuation warning, the lava flow triggered by a volcanic eruption at the end of June. The volcano's been active for years, but typically the lava has gone south toward the ocean. Now it's moving in the opposite direction toward restaurants and homes, shops, other businesses too. At this point, crews are starting to build out some roads. They really have been doing this for weeks. Alternatives to Highway 130, that's the main route in or out of town. But some folks here are really concerned about the possibility of isolation, of being cut off if and when that lava flow crosses their main path to the rest of the island.
I guess we know who's truly in charge there, and it's not people in that area.
It's the environment, that's for sure.
Here's our top five videos, the best videos from all around the world, including some lava photos. But first, look at some others.
Yeah, and we're going to start off with lightning. They're putting on quite the show down under in Melbourne. Yeah, residents there in Adelaide as well treated to this lightning show. A thunderstorm passed right on by. Of course, they're in spring now, leaning towards summer, the southern hemisphere. Everything's upside down and backwards.
Right, what would you expect? Number four video, here's some of that lava. Now, this red hot lava is advancing. This is on the big island of Hawaii, the Kilauea volcano. It has been continuously erupting since 1983.
Yeah, that's fascinating about this volcano. It's not one of those like big explosion type volcanoes. It's just a slow ebb. And if one of those lava flows comes your way, there's really no stopping it. I mean, look at this flow crossing over Apaa Street in Pahoa on Saturday. That is a main connection point to the town. So that's bad news.
Or was.
Or was, indeed.
Number two, lava in Pahoa destroys a shed on its way yesterday. And the lava flow continues to spread. There'll be pictures like this all week at least. People are having to evacuate, or they're just about to that point.
Yeah, I mean, there's not that much that can just go right through barbed wire fences, but lava is indeed one of those things. Here's more lava from that Kilauea volcano covering parts of the Pahoa Cemetery on Sunday. The flow moving at the time at a rate of approximately 15 to 20 yards an hour. It has advanced approximately 170 yards since last evening.
And that's a city block, 170 yards. That's pretty fast in geologic time, you know? You can upload your videos anytime at weather.com/photos. We'd love to see them. Well, new information on a tropical storm that formed in the Gulf of Mexico. Did you hear about that? We'll update it next.
And see how the weather played a role in the decision to recall millions of airbags. That's coming up after your local on the 8s. But now it's time for your trick-or-treat forecast. And if you're in Orlando, watch out for these guys.
Yeah.
Exactly. You might get scared out of your wits at Universal Orlando's Halloween Horror Nights. I know I would be. I'd be reacting just like those people. My goodness. Here's your forecast for the Orlando area. If you are into getting scared, it looks like the chance for thunderstorms could add to the scariness. That is the most frightening Dave Schwartz mask I've ever seen. Scattered storms by Friday afternoon. Leading up to that point, mostly sunny. Temps in the low to mid-80s.
Oh, it is gorgeous in Florida. Oh, we're way down to Miami right now. Tropical Update is next.
Somewhere out there, a high-tech factory is being built, preparing to manufacture world-class products. And it's happening right here in America. At WeatherTech, American workers in American factories are creating the highest quality automotive accessories, including laser-measured, custom-fit floor liners. Order yours today at WeatherTech.com or call 1-800-CAR-MATS. WeatherTech, proudly made in America.
Discover all the wonders of Atlantis with AquaVenture Water Park and the Atlantis Casino. Book now, and kids under 12 eat breakfast and dinner free with the purchase of an adult meal plan. Atlantis.
currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. This afternoon, mostly sunny. High 81. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, cloudy intervals. Low 71. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, sunshine and clouds mixed. High 83. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Right, they should be good. Oh, well, that didn't work. Henry? Gorilla? It never works. Gorilla Super Glue. Of course.
Other super glues get brittle and break. Gorilla Super Glue's rubber-toughened formula holds even after repeated drops and bumps.
Oh, thanks. You know, this reminds me of the time, and you're gone.
Gorilla Super Glue, for the toughest jobs on planet Earth.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm on it. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You're covered, Kevin.
Thanks, Melinda.
I have blah blah insurance, so person, come help.
Hey, Grandma. Dad, look who it is.
I see who it is.
Six callers ahead of us, Jimmy.
You're not helping.
Having insurance isn't the same as having State Farm. There to help you anytime, anywhere, anyway. That's getting to a better state.
Meet the lumberjack whose flannel was out of whack. Freedom to move is what he lacked. Even when woodland creatures attack. Until they put Duluth free swinging flannel on his back. With armpit gussets to whack and hack. Now he's known as a lumberjack. Duluth Trading free swinging flannel. Swinging made easy. Flannel made burly. Get it. Only at DuluthTrading.com.
So, you're saying you'll give me my credit score for free? Right. Now you're going to ask for my credit card so you can charge me on the down low 2 weeks later. Look, Credit Karma.
Are you talking to websites again?
This website says free credit scores.
Oh, Credit Karma. Yeah, it's really free. Look, you don't even have to put in your credit card information.
What?
PCmatic won first place in the virus bulletin rap test. The most prestigious security competition in the world. PCmatic from the United States outperformed all its foreign competition. This victory is independent third-party validation that PCmatic is the best at blocking viruses and keeping your computers safe from modern threats like CryptoLocker. At $50 for 5 computers for 1 year, PCmatic is a great value, but PCmatic is much more. PCmatic makes your computers faster and more reliable even after years of use. PCmatic supports Windows XP, keeping it secure and running as good as the day you bought it. PCmatic has a full, no questions asked 30-day money-back guarantee. And PCmatic is supported by Americans whose first language is English. To get top-rated, world-class security that also keeps your computers running great, go to PCmatic.com. That's PCmatic.com.
Professionalism is going to make you, as a business owner, more successful. Just right off the bat.
Vistaprint.com.
3 nights of weather. You shouldn't watch alone.
What was that?
Our Halloween marathon, Wicked in the Weather, starting Wednesday night at 8 on the Weather Channel.
Well, Mother Nature's handing out both tricks and treats this Friday. So what will you get?
Well, we're going to go state by state at the top of the hour for your Halloween forecast. But first, storm specialist Michael Lowry has the tropical update.
He's a treat.
Right, Mark. We're going to start all the way here in the North Indian Ocean, specifically here in the Arabian Sea. Maybe wondering why. It's because we have a cyclone. This is a hurricane strength storm. We just call them cyclones. They're the same thing, just in another part of the world. But Very unusual to get one of this strength. We get about 1 to 2 of these per year in this part of the world. But you have to go back 4 years to find one where the winds were at least 85 miles per hour. This is Cyclone Niloufer, which is moving toward the west-northwest at 2 miles per hour. So kind of creeping along here. Now, last week, it looked like it could threaten parts of Yemen and Oman. There's a lot of oil production in this part of the world. That's why it's really a big interest to us. But the other thing now is it's hooking to the right, we think, toward India and Pakistan, where there are a lot of people, millions of people, in fact, in its path. Look at it. It has an eye, very nice formed central dense overcast, meaning those very strong thunderstorms right around the eye. And it's getting picked up now, starting to move. Again, it's moving more toward the west-northwest, but it'll begin to move toward the east coming up as we move into the week. Here is the forecast from the forecast agency out there, the India Meteorological Department. They're moving it off toward the northeast and intensifying it to 115 mile per hour, Category 3 cyclone there by Wednesday morning, and then moving into parts of either Pakistan or northern India come the latter part of the week, come on Friday. But this could be a big story here. There are a lot of people that live out there in this part of the world. Let's talk about what's happening in the Western Hemisphere. We got a lot of rings here on our map today, surprisingly so, because it's been pretty quiet over the past few weeks, other than Gonzalo there that raked over Bermuda. We have Tropical Storm Hannah, which we're going to talk about in just a minute. I do want to focus your attention, though, on this invest to the south of Mexico. The Hurricane Center is giving it a very high chance of becoming our next tropical depression or named storm. Mark, the models are kind of split right now, but some of them moving it either out to sea or some of them even curling it back to Mexico. We'll have more on this as the days progress. Back to you.
Thanks, Michael. And, you know, listen up before getting into your car, especially if you live in a humid part of the country, because millions of vehicles are being recalled. And get this, weather is partly to blame.
My car's up there. I'll have to look into that. Mm-hmm. Meteorologist Dick Walker tells us high humidity could cause your airbag to malfunction.
Investigators say excessive and prolonged exposure to moisture in the air causes a chemical reaction in the bags that can make the airbag's metal canisters explode, shooting deadly shrapnel out toward drivers and passengers. At least 4 people have died from the very devices meant to save their lives. As many as 12 million vehicles have been recalled for repairs.
This is the biggest that I've been involved in, being with Honda. Really, we haven't had anything of this scale, and so it's huge.
The recall affects airbags on some automobiles made between 2001 and 2008 by BMW, Toyota, Honda, Chrysler, Ford, Subaru, Mazda, GM, Mitsubishi, and Nissan. But many drivers who live outside the recall zone are worried, including this mother from Chicago.
My kids are the most important thing, most important people in my life right now, and I really want to make sure that they're safe.
So how high does the humidity have to be in order for there to be a problem? Investigators don't yet have a definitive answer, but a huge part of the country sees high humidity with dew points 60 degrees and above at least part of the year. And that's why many drivers and lawmakers, too, want a nationwide recall. If the recall is extended throughout the country, the number of recalled automobiles would rise to nearly 30 million. I'm meteorologist Nick Walker.
Thanks, Nick. The weather in your airbag, who knew?
Right. A slow-moving river of fire is threatening dozens of homes.
Yeah, still to come on Weather Center Live, lava from the Kilauea volcano is inching closer to a small Hawaiian town. We're going to show you the damage it's already done and tell you why some people could lose everything.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. This afternoon, mostly sunny. High 81. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tonight, cloudy intervals, low 71. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 83. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
wind and rain and even snow. How about that guy, huh? Nice. Hey, October is a tricky month when it comes to weather. You can get anything. And this week, all eyes will need to be focused on the forecast for Halloween.
Why'd you put such a scary mask on already?
Get out of here. Well, yeah, this is my natural look.
I see. We take an early look at what's in store for you and where you may have to dress the children in layers underneath their costume.
It's kind of like a horror show happening in slow motion.
One of our United States is threatened by a river of fire. We take a look at the speed of the lava as a town is on edge, awaiting evacuation orders.
And in this case, you can call it a comeback. What was once Hurricane Ana is back, causing havoc for the Pacific Northwest. What's in store and why it's not the only former hurricane with a very unusual route. From the Weather Channel headquarters in Atlanta, you are watching Weather Center Live. And thanks so much for joining us today. I'm Mark Elliott, in for Alex Wilson.
And I'm Dave Schwartz. Well, the hallowed evening is fast approaching. And there's going to be some very ghostly and ghastly weather in the Northeast. More on that in a minute. But the other corner of the country is still in store for heavy rain, storms, wind. We know where that is.
Yeah, the Pacific Northwest. Mm-hmm. And this is scary enough without the ghouls and goblins hitting the streets. People near Seattle trying to restore power today after winds toppled trees and power lines. In fact, right now there's still more than 10,000 customers in Washington and Oregon without power from the first storm, which hit over the weekend. Plus, a sailor was killed when he was blown overboard during a race near Olympia, Washington. And now people there have to get ready for the next series of strong storms. And here's Dave with a look at those.
And even though this coming storm is probably not going to be as strong as the last one, what I'm concerned about is this. We've had a lot of rain this past week. Look at this year in Seattle, about a foot above average. So we've got a lot of water in the ground, and we've got some trees whose root systems have been weakened by the last big blow that we had on Saturday. Well, the winds from this one could be strong enough to take down kind of the low-hanging fruit. You know what I mean? So that's something to think about. If you know there's a tree that needs to be taken down or it's dead or dying or something, you know, just know that more winds could take it down and it could be from this storm. No, not this storm. But if we take a look at the satellite image further away from radar range, we see the swirl right up here. And here's the cold front, low pressure at the surface, and that will hit the Pacific Northwest. Right around evening rush for Seattle, a little after that here in Portland. And the winds are going to diminish here tomorrow. Rain will change to like a shower here, a shower there, that kind of thing, and probably be with us on Wednesday. Another wave of low pressure develops along that front. Very wet system, in part because it dug into the tropics where moisture levels run high year-round. Speaking of tropics, here is Michael Lowry. He's live in the lab to talk about this.
Dave, that's exactly right. This system has a little bit of DNA from what was a tropical system, Ana. I want to take you back, show you on our globe here in the lab where this was a week ago. This was Ana 1 week ago, about 2,500 miles to the southwest of the U.S., just to the west of Hawaii there. It was a tropical storm at the time. It's re-strengthened, actually, into a hurricane late last week into the weekend. You can see this as it progresses very, very quickly. You see that little eye that popped up and now moving in with that big non-tropical Pacific system into parts of the Pacific Northwest. Now, this isn't a tropical system anymore, but enough of that energy getting into that big storm system that's now moving into parts of Washington and Oregon. So we're going to have to watch for those gale force winds just offshore, the Olympic National Park, the Olympic Mountains, even some flooding possibilities there in the Skokomish River. Just goes to show you these systems, they sometimes have a long life even after their tropical system. Dave, back to you.
All right, thank you, Michael. Can you hang in there? Yes, thank you. Switching gears just a minute. Something happened this weekend this morning that was really kind of weird. You know, we got a new named tropical storm in the Atlantic Basin that might have taken some people by surprise. What's up with that?
It did, Dave. When I woke up this morning, I myself was pretty surprised by this one. It was one that we were only giving a 10% chance of development early this morning, the Hurricane Center was, and then becoming a lot more impressive looking as the morning went on. I want to show you what it is now. This is Tropical Storm Hannah, not to be confused with Anna out there in the Pacific, winds of 40 miles per hour, so borderline tropical storm strength. 39 miles per hour is tropical storm intensity, now moving inland over parts of Honduras and Nicaragua. Here's what it looks like on the visible picture. And when the sun came up, we found that spin down there near the surface of the ocean, and that was confirmed by our satellites and some of the observations there near shore. Tropical storm warnings are up, but not so much about the wind. It's a rain threat here, potential heavy rainfall mark into parts of Nicaragua and Honduras this week. Back to you.
Thanks, Michael. We'll be watching that carefully. Of course, also on a lot of people's minds, the Northeast. What will Halloween be like? Here's a hint. You'll need the layers again in places like New York, D.C., and Boston. In fact, we're going to go back to fall across much of the Northeast Corridor, right? We had seen the warm air coming into play. Now we're seeing that cooler air come back in. Northwest winds dominating. That will bring us back to near average, but when you compare that to where we've been and where we're still going to be over the next couple of days, that change is going to be very dramatic. From 80 in D.C. and 70 in New York, anywhere from 10 to 15 degrees above average, to quickly transitioning back to near average temperatures. You see the greens on the map, they're going to be spilling their way towards the northeast coastline. Boston, 56. New York, 58. Actually, by Thursday, switching to below average temperatures. And in New York, where the average high is 61, it means by Friday, Halloween Friday, only in the mid-50s for your high temp. And trick-or-treating at night, of course, will be cooler. Plus, we might see some of the first snowflakes behind this cold air. Cold air will spill down behind a cold front moving through the northeast corridor, right as an area of low pressure forms, kind of a clipper style that goes just off the coast and tries to throw some snow into the northeast corridor. That transition, Dave, will be pretty impressive from rain to snow. Maybe Saturday in the northeast for snow for the northeast corridor. Over to you.
I love to look at the lights, the street lights, and watch that first snow come down. Well, after the Halloween thrills, there could even be more chills. Later this hour, we're going to show you who could see their first snowfall of the season by this weekend. Here's a look at some of that lava as it heads toward homes in Hawaii.
Cooper engineers its tires, not just for performance, but real life performance. So before you get in, get going. Get gone. You need to get a tire that gets you. Because life's a road trip. Come on, let's go. Buy four qualifying Cooper tires and get up to a $70 prepaid card by mail. See retailer for details.
Energizer Ultimate Lithium, the world's longest lasting AA battery in high-tech devices. Up to six times longer than the other leading brand.
Don't let back pain limit your life. I'm Arlene Mandrell of the Mandrell Sisters, and I'd like to share a solution with you.
Get the DDS 500 with no out-of-pocket cost to you with Medicare and other major insurances. The only patented back support that provides adjustable traction, the DDS 500 adjusts to your comfort level and fits discreetly under clothes.
So what are you waiting for? Call Allied Home Medical now, 1-800-230-6099.
Sunday nights, the Weather Channel unravels nature's darkest secrets. Every Sunday, a new tale of weather legend.
It may have just looked like a storm, but they were dealing with something far worse.
American Supernatural, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 71, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy, high 83, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tuesday night, a few clouds from time to time, low 71, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
coldest weather ever caught on camera.
Oh my God.
Tonight, tomorrow night, every weeknight, Wild Weather at 8 on the Weather Channel.
I think everyone I knew growing up had a Lazy Boy recliner in the house. So it's funny that my family's favorite place to sit is made by Lazy Boy too. Seriously. All this. Lazy Boy Furniture Galleries. Live life comfortably.
What if there was a credit card where the reward was that new car smell and the freedom of the open road? A card that gave you that I'm 16 and just got my first car feeling. Presenting the Buy Power Card from Capital One. Redeem earnings toward part or even all of a new Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, or Cadillac with no limits. So every time you use it, you're not just shopping for goods. You're shopping for something great. Learn more at buypowercard.com.
You may not be a prepper now, but you will be. Whether the next disaster is man-made or wrought by Mother Nature, you need a plan.
WiseFoodStorage.com's emergency gourmet meals are made in the USA, delicious, easy to prepare, just add water, and packaged and proportioned perfectly, eliminating waste and creating a shelf life of up to 25 years. Why face your next emergency on an empty stomach? Request your free sample today at WiseFoodStorage.com.
It's real. It's now or never. You know, you pack and you got to get out.
It's going to be sad watching our house go down.
We're all in needles and pins, you know, waiting and waiting.
It's kind of like a horror show happening in slow motion.
We're praying really hard that it'll spare us on this area here because my whole family is in this subdivision.
I can't even imagine what that's like watching that slow motion disaster as it creeps towards an American town. The Kilauea volcano has been erupting for years, but this current lava flow really started in June. And today, lava from that volcano is threatening more than 50 homes in Pahoa. The lava, 2,000 degrees, hot enough to torch anything in its path. And it has traversed that 23 miles or so from Kilauea towards Pahoa. The pace has been slow and steady as the lobe has kind of split into two. One of those lobes moving about 10 to 15 yards per hour. That's about a football field every day. The other moving much slower, but anything in the path of either lobe has been completely burned and disintegrated. Because of that heat, officials have been going door to door, letting people know that evacuations could begin at any point. In fact, one of the most destructive moments started yesterday. The lava flow moved into the Pahoa Cemetery, covered several burial plots, and burned monuments that had been there for decades. And homes could actually be next. And for a little perspective on what has been happening with this volcano, you know, check this out. We have seen the Kilauea has been erupting continuously since 1983. 16 homes destroyed in 83, 14 in 86, and 150 homes were actually burned when a lava flow came into that neck of the woods. Dave, for more on this, over to you.
Well, we want to welcome Dr. Charles Mandeville. Now, he is a program coordinator with the U.S. Geological Survey, and he joins us by phone. Good to have you with us here, Dr. Mandeville.
Thank you for having me.
Now, we understand that you are tracking two lobes of the lava right now. Can you give us an update on both of them?
Yeah, the northernmost lobe is about 40 meters wide, and that's the one that passed Pahoa Cemetery yesterday, and it's moving at a rate of about 240 to 360 meters per day, and that's as of 5 p.m. Right now, the faster finger, the northern one, is about 300 meters downslope of Apaha Street and 660 meters upslope from Pahoa Village Road. The lower one is basically traveling at about 9 meters per hour as of 5 p.m. last night, and the two lobes may actually join as they come through the cemetery near the northeast end of the pasture. Now, certainly these things can be outrun. However, they can't be stopped, and they incinerate everything in their path.
Can they be diverted away from people's homes, for example?
There have been incidences in other countries where lava flows have been diverted, but that is not something that is done in Hawaii, actually.
I see.
There are strong cultural reasons for not doing so.
Uh-huh. Now, we've heard about methane gas explosions near the lava flow. In 30 seconds, can you explain just what happens, how that happens?
Yes. As the lava flow traverses vegetation, it actually incinerates it, and some of those gases given off from the burning vegetation can be trapped by the lava,
mm-hmm.
but eventually sufficiently high pressure will build up so that a small explosion occurs. Fortunately, these aren't the major hazard because they're small explosions, and they haven't really lofted rocks out of a crater.
Thank you, Dr. Mandeville from the U.S. Geological Survey on that lava flow in Hawaii.
From Bermuda to the UK to Greece, the impacts of Hurricane Gonzalo have been widespread. Coming up next, the eye-opening path this storm and its energy have taken and the damage it's done around the world.
Start something special in the all-new CR-V Touring from Honda.
Did you know? Fresh Step Extreme Lightweight Litter isn't just light. It's also the best lightweight for eliminating odors. Amazing, right? For guaranteed odor elimination, try Fresh Step Extreme. Lightweight.
Yoplait Light is now better than ever. It still melts in your mouth with 90 calories and is now aspartame-free. Yoplait Light. It is so good, it's better than ever.
Wouldn't it be nice if we focused less on the number and more on how the fit makes us feel? Start your day bursting with real berries and slip into size sassy with Special K.
Maybe you didn't know, people with the flu can spread it up to 6 feet away. Or that flu can make chronic conditions worse. Maybe you didn't know any of the stuff your Rite Aid pharmacist knows. But now that you've gotten your flu shot at Rite Aid, maybe you don't need to.
Put on your thinking caps. Evaporation rate equals 700 times the mean temperature divided by 100 minus the latitude plus 15 times temperature minus dew point temperature divided by 80 minus temperature times...
Every Wednesday, Bravo brings back its original recipe.
Welcome to Top Chef.
And look who's a judge this season.
I don't get a lot of the ginger in the cherries.
It's a little abrupt to get the feedback right away.
This is Top Chef, and I didn't come here to toss salad.
Oh. Top Chef is supersized.
I gladly eat a lot more of it.
Wednesday, October 15th at 10/9. Central, only by Bravo.
Brought to you by the South Florida Mercedes-Benz dealers, featuring the Mercedes-Benz 2015 GLA and Mercedes-Benz 2015 C-Class, or go to mbsouthflorida.com.
There is something in the people, something in the sand, there's something in the air, something in the water, something in the night, and it's something you can only find here. Jamaica, home of all right. Go to visitjamaica.com or call a travel agent today.
Call will also receive $250 off any hair loss solution from Hair Club. Call now.
Every Sunday, a new tale of weather legend. American Supernatural, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 71. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy, high 83. Winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tuesday night, a few clouds from time to time, low 71. Winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Nothing ruins a good Halloween costume like needing that winter coat. And unfortunately, you're going to need them this Friday. We're going to talk temperatures coming up at the bottom of the hour. But even as we're talking about wintry-like temperatures, we still have tropical weather going on across the globe. So first, let's talk about that tropical update in the lab with Michael Lowry and Dave Schwartz. Guys, over to you.
Hurricane season doesn't end till the end of November. And we've got something brand new. You know, we've talked about how quiet a season it's been.
Yep.
But we've had more than the average number of hurricanes in the Atlantic. They just haven't hit the United States.
Right. No, it's. I mean, we've had activity this year. I think, you know, when it's all said and done, we'll look back at the season and say, it was a pretty normal hurricane season.
Well, where's the latest little thing, and what's that likely to do?
Well, let's show you here, Dave. Let's go back to last Tuesday night when we had Tropical Depression 9 form to the west of the Yucatan Peninsula, and we could actually track this all the way across the Yucatan. Through the weekend, it sort of briefly emerged into the Caribbean, but then back over Honduras and Nicaragua. And sure enough, this morning, we woke up and we found tropical storm strength winds down there. So now we have Tropical Storm Hannah here just off the coast of Honduras. In fact, inland now over the coast of Honduras and Nicaragua. 40 mile per hour winds. So borderline here, tropical storm. And it's moving further inland. It's not really so much about the winds here, and we've been saying that. It's about the rainfall that it could bring, especially here to parts of Honduras. They certainly don't need it after the past week. It's been a really wet go over the past several days.
So there's nothing close to the U.S., but here in Central America, we're getting hit.
Yes. I mean, this one's, fortunately for us, big old high pressure to the north, and that's not going to allow this thing to go north. It's got to go south, and it's going to go further inland and just sort of rain itself out here over the next few days.
Well, thanks for the update. That's Michael Lowry, part one. Back to you, Mark.
Yeah, and you know, we're going to stay in the lab for part two of Michael Lowry, and we saw the history of Hannah, but we want to take a look at the history of Gonzalo as well. Of course, here are the many faces of Gonzalo. Made landfall in Bermuda as a Category 2 hurricane on October 17th, but the system kept going, bringing rough winds and surf to portions of the UK, and then eventually snowfall to the Alps, right? So here to take a look at the longevity of this system is once again Michael Lowry.
I'm back.
They're back.
Hey, let's start with Gonzalo because this was, to me, the more interesting one of the two. It was one I found to be the most interesting hurricane, one of the most interesting hurricanes in the Atlantic this hurricane season because it was the strongest we saw in almost 4 years. It raked over Bermuda of a weaker hurricane, Category 2 strength.
Sure.
And then weakened there just to the east of Nova Scotia and Canada.
I just love thinking about the pure statistical chances of about a 30-mile eye perfectly going over about a 20-mile island in a vast ocean of real estate.
Yeah, I mean, we were all amazed at that. And, I mean, it did bring a lot of damage there to Bermuda. But then it wasn't done, Mark.
Yeah.
I mean, like you were saying, it kind of wrapped up like Anna in the Pacific with this non-tropical big Atlantic storm, rather, and then moved over parts of the U.K., brought 108 mile per hour wind gusts to Scotland, closed the airports there across parts of Manchester, even delayed and canceled flights into Heathrow in London, and then down over parts of Europe, bringing flooding to Greece, as you were saying, and then now snow to the Alps.
Yeah, and you don't usually think about tropical moisture adding into snow, but we've seen that before as well. I believe it was Sandy brought snow well inland.
In fact, I think Sandy was the first Hurricane Center advisory that I can remember seeing snowfall totals in the public forecast. But then there's what's going on in the Pacific. That was Anna, which actually started about the same time as Gonzalo did. This is October the 14th, so about 2 weeks ago. That one, fortunately for Hawaii, there was a time where we thought this could impact the Big Island Island as a hurricane, but stayed just far enough to their south. Did bring some rainfall here over parts of the northern islands there in Oahu and Kauai. And look, very briefly last week, got an actual eye there as a hurricane after it passed to the west of Hawaii. And now, as we've been saying, it's sort of become wrapped up, enveloped within this much larger storm system that's now pushing into parts of western Canada.
But this huge Pacific storm system that now has tropical moisture with it is pushing towards the Pacific Northwest, which just had a huge storm system come through with several inches of rain and wind damage and power outages that they're still dealing with now.
52 advisories were written on Ana. That's an incredible number of advisories and 2 weeks worth of forecast from the Central Pacific Hurricane Center.
Quite the legacy for both of these storms. Dave, back to you.
All right, we leave the tropics now. Cold air for the Northeast this weekend, and that could mean scenes like this for somebody. We'll tell you where the flakes will start and where as Weather Center Live continues.
Sir, we're going to need you on the runway.
Theraflu starts to get to work in your body in just 5 minutes. Theraflu breaks you free from your worst cold and flu symptoms. Theraflu, serious power.
Zantac heartburn alert. Stop. Nexium can take 24 hours to work. Zantac's different. Zantac rushes relief in as little as 30 minutes. For relief without the wait, try Zantac. No pill relieves heartburn faster.
The Dueler tires on Terrence Knighton's truck are engineered to be Bridgestone's best SUV tires. And now they have an 80,000-mile treadwear warranty.
Guess we're going to be here a while.
First time on a treadmill?
What are you saying?
I'm just saying.
With an 80,000-mile treadwear warranty, the Dueler tires are Bridgestone's best SUV tires. Go to BridgestoneTire.com to find a Bridgestone dealer near you.
Ring, ring.
Progresso.
I can't believe I'm eating bacon and rich creamy cheese before my sister's wedding.
Well, it's only 100 calories, so you'll be ready for that dress.
Uh-huh.
You don't love the dress?
I love my sister.
40 flavors, 100 calories or less.
Andrew, Rita, Sandy. Meet Chris, Jackie, Joe. Minor damage or major disaster. When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
I've had it with my moderate to severe plaque psoriasis. The frustration, covering up. So I talked with my doctor. He prescribed Embryl. Embryl is clinically proven to provide clearer skin. Many people saw 75% clearance in 3 months, and Embryl helped keep skin clearer at 6 months.
Embryl may lower your ability to fight infections. Serious, sometimes fatal events including infections, tuberculosis, lymphoma, other cancers, nervous system and blood disorders, and allergic reactions have occurred. Before starting Embryl, your doctor should test you for tuberculosis and discuss whether you've been to a region where certain fungal infections are common. You should not start Embryl if you have an infection like the flu. Tell your doctor if you're prone to infections, have cuts or sores, have had hepatitis B, have been treated for heart failure, or if you have symptoms such as persistent fever, bruising, bleeding, or paleness.
Finally, clearer skin for more than a few days, weeks, or months. Embryl works for me. Ask your dermatologist if you can have clearer skin with Embryl.
7 a.m. on AMHQ.
Let's get you in front of today's weather.
The biggest weather hour anywhere.
What a gorgeous start.
Weekday mornings on the Weather Channel. The wildest weather ever caught on camera.
Oh my God.
Tonight, tomorrow night, every weeknight, wild weather at 8 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 71, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy, high 83, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tuesday night, a few clouds from time to time, low 71, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Thursday night this fall.
What is it that produces these things?
The Weather Channel unlocks the secrets of the Earth. The all-new season continues tonight at 9 on the Weather Channel.
A town on edge as a slow-moving disaster threatens homes, land, and roads in Hawaii.
Coming up, how an eruption months ago is just now forcing officials to consider evacuations. Thanks so much for staying with us in Weather Center Live. I'm Mark Elliott in for Alex Wilson today.
And I'm Dave Schwartz. Well, that lava flow you just saw is providing amazing images, obviously, but a very real danger to people who live there. It's a part of one of the most unpredictable times of year when it comes to the weather here stateside.
Yeah, this week marks the 3-year anniversary of the Snowtober storm. Remember that one? It was also known as a 2011 Halloween nor'easter, and this one was quite the trick. Trick-or-treating had to be canceled due to damage and power outages. 3.2 million homes and businesses in 12 states lost power. Some parts of Connecticut were without power for 11 days, and damage estimates, Dave, $1 to $3 billion with a B, dollars. Nothing quite that bad in store this year, but we are still watching for some messy weather.
And with Halloween coming up, I mean, people don't want messy weather, you know? Perhaps you celebrated Halloween. Many of our towns had little Halloween celebrations on the square and downtown to get that out of the way the weekend before. Well, all right, no matter what plans you have kids, you have no kids, Halloween, no Halloween. One big story, at least for this part of the week, is that it's warming up. Look at Chicago at 74. It's our current temperature. We've got some sunshine, too. Wind south-southwest bringing that warm and a little bit humid air up here, too, gusting to 26 miles an hour. But that warm air is not going to last long. In Dickinson, North Dakota right now, the temperature is 39 with a wind chill of 28. That's what's headed for Chicago in a somewhat modified form. St. Louis now 82, almost a record. You get in on the cooler air beginning tomorrow and tomorrow night. And then it heads to the northeast. But high temperatures will be back to just near average from this first shot, at least through Wednesday. Then there's a second shot for the Midwest and Northeast. But look at this. Today, 71 in Des Moines. Tomorrow, 56. That's a 15-degree turnaround. St. Louis back from the 80s to the 60s and barely 60s by the time Wednesday gets here. And we'll see the same kind of transition in the Northeast, too. Warming up the next couple of days. Oh, there's Chicago. Thanks for making an appearance here. Back to fall for the Northeast after a couple of warmer days for us. Let's check in here. Temperatures tomorrow, 71 New York City, 80 in Washington, but we'll watch that cooler air move in from the west. It'll get here to the East Coast Wednesday night. Mark, back to you.
So, Dave, what about Halloween and just after? Believe it or not, we could be talking about early November snow in places like the Steel City. That's right, Pittsburgh. Get ready. We could have some snow. Now, it's not out of the question to see snow this time of year. In fact, the earliest measurable snow was October 18th. So you can have snow even earlier than right now. The average first day of measurable snow is November 14th. So we're right smack dab in the middle. So there's certainly a possibility of seeing some snow this time of year. And you know what? The first flakes for some could come as early as this weekend. Let's get into the setup here, why we're seeing that chance for snow. And we got to go all the way up to Alaska. All these bright colors are the colder cloud tops that we're looking at from above using the satellite. And you might say, well, this is a huge storm. It's got to be that, right? Well, actually, it's this. Yeah, we can look at this another way using the models and using what's known as vorticity or the mid-level spin in the atmosphere. We can follow that little impulse drop down out of Canada, go across the bay, through the Great Lakes, pick up steam, head across the Northeast and go right off the coastline by Saturday afternoon. So that's the spin in the atmosphere. That means we'll have some rising motion. So the ingredients, right? Rising motion and for snow, cold air. And precipitation. Well, we're going to have the cold air in place. That mid-level feature, this upper-level disturbance, is going to set up shop. It's going to help to bring down the cold air. Then, with that impulse that we are following, we'll also see the precipitation moving in. And right on cue, you're going to see rain showers Friday that enter the picture by Friday night and change over to snow showers. And look what happens by Saturday. We haven't seen this much blue on the map in a long time. Syracuse, Burlington, snow. On Saturday. Dave, back to you.
Holy Toledo, my gosh. Well, here's a look at Seattle. It's quiet today. No wind storms, no trees coming down, no more power outages. We're still recovering from Saturday's big blow, but there's another blow out there. 53 degrees right now in Seattle, 51 in Olympia, the capital city. And down in Portland, we're also in the 50s. It's been very wet this year, west of the Cascades. 29 inches of rain in Portland, that's 5 inches above average, and more is on the way. At least two storms will come in here. They'll just barge right in. You don't even have to open the door. This one will be coming in tonight, another one Wednesday night and Thursday. Here comes our latest storm, and it is juiced with some tropical moisture from Anna, the one that doused Hawaii about a week and a half ago. It's headed for the Pacific Northwest. So we're going to get some rain, and we're going to get some wind here, too, tonight and tomorrow morning. So on the headlands, of course, right along the coast, that's where we really catch it. Lincoln County, Oregon, for example. A lot of wind here tonight. Gale warnings are in effect. Rain for Seattle, rain for Portland all night tonight. That'll taper off to just hit or miss showers tomorrow, and it'll be noticeably cooler tomorrow. Rain moves into Montana, maybe a little snow or ice initially because it's pretty cold out there right now. The atmosphere will get warmer. Then the next area of low pressure comes up along that front, brings more rain, possibly heavy for coastal Oregon, western Oregon, including Portland. Wednesday will be a very wet day. Highs near 60. Back to you, Mark.
And you know, we've had a bit of a quiet year when it comes to tornadoes, or at least we had a quiet year until we got to October. Just last week, we had an EF1 tornado touchdown in Washington State. Our severe weather expert breaks down the tornado tally and shows you why November is no time to let your guard down.
Because of the outbreak of more than 40 tornadoes back in mid-October, this month is actually above average for number of tornadoes. It's just the second time in 2014, the previous in June. Here's what the numbers look like. October through the 24th, we've had 69 preliminary tornadoes. That's 57% above the average to this date, which would be 44, and more than the whole month typically averages, which is 57. So, like I say, we're going to be above average. Here's what the year-to-date total looks like. 820 tornadoes, that's a lot, but it's 31% below the 10-year average of 1,191. So we've had a lot of tornadoes, but fortunately, we have been below average. We'll hope it continues that way, but not necessarily so. What does November typically hold? Well, if you look at the big picture of things, on average, we go from 57 tornadoes in October down to 55 in November, but that doesn't necessarily tell the whole story. Certainly, it's way down from the peak month, which is typically the month of May, but it does not tell the whole story because sometimes some Novembers can have big outbreaks that give two or three times the average. Look at this outbreak back in November 1992. That one had 105 tornadoes, and all five of these rank in the 50 biggest tornado outbreaks for any month in the United States. So while every November is not very active, sometimes with that Gulf of Mexico moisture being drawn northward by low pressure systems and the jet stream coming south, kind of like what happens in the spring, we can get big tornado outbreaks. So don't let your guard down. Keep checking the weather and stay safe. Back to you.
Well, still to come on Weather Center Live, a lava flow on the move since June is inching closer to a small town in Hawaii. Coming up, the final steps before a possible evacuation.
Plus, lava is a big part of our top five countdown. Stick around. You're just minutes away from seeing our number one video of the day.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 71, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy, high 83, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tuesday night, a few clouds from time to time, low 71, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
a pip.
It's part of a Hershey's bar.
We break it.
We bite it.
We sneak it.
We smush it.
We savor it.
We love it.
Hershey's is mine.
Yours.
Our chocolate.
Energizer Ultimate Lithium, the world's longest-lasting AA battery in high-tech devices. Up to 6 times longer than the other leading brand.
Maybe you didn't know. People with the flu can spread it up to 6 feet away. Or that flu can make chronic conditions worse. Maybe you didn't know any of the stuff your Rite Aid pharmacist knows. But now that you've gotten your flu shot at Rite Aid, maybe you don't need to.
I've always seen No-No on TV, and I always wondered if it worked. And it definitely, I can see what everybody talks about now.
It's not a razor. It's not a laser. It's No-No from Radiancy, the number one hair removal system in the world.
It's absolutely okay. No pain.
Can't believe the difference, Al. It's almost hair-free.
No-No gives you no hair with no pain.
Well, I saw it on TV, and they said it was painless, right? I didn't really believe it, but now that I'm trying it, it feels completely painless.
And now, No-No is better than ever. Introducing the new No-No Pro. It's up to 35% more powerful. Imagine never having to shave again.
I like a close shave.
Absolutely.
And this is better than that. I mean, it's gone.
No more facial hair. No more embarrassment.
I've always been self-conscious of my hairline, so putting my hair back, this will be perfect for me.
And for that man in your life, there's No-No for him, too.
It looks like just like you've got a fresh wax, but, like, you don't have to go through all the pain.
Call now, and we'll send you the cordless No-No Pro in your choice of colors. Featuring an LCD display, it comes with up to 5 treatment levels. Plus, we'll include everything you need to get rid of your unwanted hair. A set of Thermacon tips, specially designed for your face and body. A buffer pad to exfoliate and polish your skin. Plus, act now, and we'll send you the No-No travel case as a free gift. And get this, you can try No-No risk-free for not 30 days, but 60 days with our triple guarantee. If you are not 100% satisfied, return it and we'll refund the purchase price, refund the shipping, and even pay the return postage. Try No-No risk-free today.
I need to get myself one of these right now.
Absolutely.
For your 60-day trial, go to nonopro.com or call 1-800-955-2390. That's 1-800-955-2390.
From the very minute you have this idea that you want to be in business, you need to have that card.
Presentation is everything because they're not only first impression of you, but now you're handing them this product that really is kind of going to define your business in their mind pretty quickly.
You want a very thick card that feels nice in your client's hand.
I think it's nice to have a choice because sometimes you want a glossy card, but for other projects, I don't necessarily want all that.
Your business card is a reflection of you. It should say exactly what you want. With a range of design, stock, and finish options at Vistaprint, it will. Get 500 business cards starting at just $9.99. Just enter promo code TV500 at Vistaprint.com.
That business card, when I make a connection with someone, has to be phenomenal. It has to be elegant and invoke all the things that Diamond stands for.
Just that professionalism is going to make you, as a business owner, more successful just right off the bat.
Vistaprint.com.
Don't let back pain limit your life. I'm Arlene Mandrell, the Mandrell Sisters, and I'd like to share a solution with you.
Get the DDS 500 with no out-of-pocket cost to you with Medicare and other major insurances. The only patented back support that provides adjustable traction, the DDS 500 adjusts to your comfort level and fits discreetly under clothes.
So what are you waiting for? Call Allied Home Medical now, 1-800-230-6099.
That is the sound of lava eating up somebody's lawn. This is in Hawaii. This lava is slowly smoldering everything in its path. And in its path right now, part of a small Hawaiian town and the main road people there used to get in and out.
Yeah, and that threat of isolation is why the people of Pahoa are getting ready to evacuate, even preparing for the possibility that they may never see their homes again. NBC's Haley Jackson in Hawaii with a closer look at the damage.
Good morning. This roadblock is about as close as almost anybody can get to the lava flow, which is about a half a mile from where we're standing. People are packing up. They're getting ready to leave their homes, possibly as early as today. Even though this river of lava is taking about 5 hours to cover the length of a football field right now, that's actually the fastest it's been moving in days. Unstoppable, unrelenting, and heading straight toward this village of Pahoa. Hawaiian officials are going door to door to the 40 or 50 homes or so covered by this new evacuation warning, the lava flow triggered by a volcanic eruption at the end of June. The volcano has been active for years, but typically the lava has gone south toward the ocean. Now it's moving in the opposite direction toward restaurants and homes, shops, other businesses too. At this point, crews are starting to build out some roads. They really have been doing this for weeks. Alternatives to Highway 130, that's the main route in or out of town. But some folks here are really concerned about the possibility of isolation, of being cut off if and when that lava flow crosses their main path to the rest of the island.
Talk about a sinking feeling, huh?
Yeah, apparently it adds a 70 to 100 miles to go around the other way if that road is cut off.
If that road's cut off, yeah. Wow. Well, today we are focusing in on our best five videos from around the world, including some of the lava pictures from Hawaii. So let's get started. Number five, a huge lava flow in Puna, Hawaii. It's spreading on the Big Island. Residents are preparing for evacuations. They may have to leave their homes as if this were a forest fire.
Yeah, and with the potential of never being able to come back to a home that's still standing.
Well, what would they have left?
As we heard earlier in the hour, this is part of the culture. There is no, you don't stop the lava in Hawaii. You
apparently
don't try to reroute
sacred.
It. Yeah. Here's number four, dozens of residents on alert as this lava advances on that Big Island of Hawaii. The Kilauea volcano responsible for this lava. It is one of those volcanoes that's been slowly oozing out lava in continuous eruption since 1983. It's not like the volcanoes that you would see, say, outside of the Pacific Northwest, where there would be a cone and an explosion.
Right.
It doesn't work that way.
Or the famous Vesuvius, Pompeii, right?
Yes.
That did laid waste to that. Number three, this video shows the lava flowing across the street. Same idea, just some more pictures. And I guess we can't hear anything, but apparently there's methane gas, too, that is poisoning the air. So it's at least a double threat.
Yeah, and some of that methane is actually under the ground from, you know, decomposing old plant matter.
Sure.
And then when the heat gets nearby, it explodes. Because this lava takes out anything in its path. Look at the shed here on the left side of the screen. There it is on the right side of the screen.
Well, that's
just a little bit later.
Right, it's a piece of cake for that. And number one, lava again. This time, a rather macabre scene. At the Pahoa Cemetery on Sunday, the flow was moving at a rate of approximately 15 to 20 yards per hour, which is pretty fast, Mark, when you think about it, and had advanced approximately one city block by last evening. So it's on the move.
Yeah, you can upload your videos anytime at weather.com/photos. So if you've got something you want us to see, that's the way to get it to us.
And new information on a tropical storm that formed in the Gulf of Mexico just last night, right?
Yeah.
That's when it was named. Well, that's ahead on your tropical update.
And see how the weather played a role in the decision to recall millions of airbags. You wouldn't think about it, but it's involved. That's coming up after your local on the 8s.
And if you're looking for something to do while eating all your candy on Halloween, well, how about watching a guy tightrope between skyscrapers in the Windy City? No, it's not Jim Cantore, but he'll be there to advise Nick Wallenda as he walks between the Burnett Building and Marina Towers in Chicago Sunday. See it live at 7 on Discovery.
Engineers its tires, not just for performance, but real life performance. So before you get in, get going. Get gone. You need to get a tire that gets you. Because life's a road trip. Come on, let's go. Buy four qualifying Cooper tires and get up to a $70 prepaid card by mail. See retailer for details.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Tonight, partly cloudy, low 71, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy, high 83, winds east at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Tuesday night, a few clouds from time to time, low 71, winds east at 5 to 10 miles per hour.